Alright, what's up people? This is Sifurian, and right now we're going to be checking out episode 5 of Black Sails. Alright, very quick little recap, and I know when I say quick recap, I'm talking for about 3 minutes, but we're not doing that today. I really don't have the time. Captain Vane, he killed the owner of the whorehouse, and in turn the owner of Max. So we've got that kind of like going somewhere. It could kind of come back on Captain Vane. Or this could be the start of him kind of making a comeback, because he had kind of hit rock bottom after having like his crew desert him and stuff. But he was having like visions of some guy, or I guess you could say they're like Tom Hardy's Taboos type of flashbacks of something. And I'm not too sure, but it must have something to do with the scar that he's got on him. We also learned that Miss Barlow, she was married to Thomas Hamilton when they was in London, but she was having an affair with a guy who turned out to be Captain Flint. And when Thomas found out, he kind of went a bit stir crazy. We haven't really got any real confirmation just yet, but I think it might have led to his death. And then, of course, you've got Eleanor, who I guess you could say she's lost the trust of Mr. Scott because she lied to him. But he's also been talking to her father, and it looks like her father's got his own kind of plans and agenda, but at the same time he wants to keep Eleanor safe, and he's asked Mr. Scott for his help. What kind of led to I guess it was got kind of like a double cross to do with the guns, because the boat was just sailing off, it wasn't coming to the shore. So I think in this episode Captain Flint's going to go after it. It's about time we get off the land. Like, they're pirates, and the majority of this show has been on land. Like, you know, I don't know why, it's like come on man, we need to get out there and start doing stuff. But the big question is now, how is Flint gonna go after it without really a ship, because we don't know how well or how badly damaged the ship was when they brought it onto land to fix the hull, I think it was. And of course it was tied to those trees, the trees came out, and Marley, I think it was, he got crushed when they tried to take Randall out and save him, because Randall got caught trying to save his cat and Flint had the chop off his leg. What also led to Captain Flint not necessarily agreeing with, but kind of understanding John Silver's comments about Billy, and like, can we trust him? And yeah, I'm kind of eager to see where that's going to go, man. Right, so we're going to get into this. Let's do this, man. Okay, so the ship is at good standing. And we are out at sea.
You don't trust me, do you?
Oh.
Who's Mrs. Barlow?
Ooh. Come on, man, you two gotta have a good sit down, heart to heart.
So you can probably guess it isn't as much fun to tell stories about how your captain makes a home with a nice Puritan woman who shares his love of books.
Oh shit. Right, he referred to the books then, and when Miss Barlow was reading that book to Eleanor's father, Flint got pissed off last time. So maybe there's something to do about the books. Or something in the books.
You gave him permission, dear. We must stand by our word.
I said he could put one finger in my thumb, not three.
Then next time, charge him by the digit.
What?
From the tone of his voice, it sounded as if Mr. Noonan couldn't wait to be rid of this place and of its screeching pig of a board. His words, not mine. The last I saw him, he was seeking passage to Port Royal and then to who knows where.
You're telling me that Mr. Noonan, who just a few hours ago had the intent of seeing your captain beaten to a pulp, that Mr. Noonan decided instead to sell you his life's work?
Yes.
And you expect me to accept it based on a piece of paper and your word, and to keep my mouth shut about it, when any half-wit can see that there's foul play at hand?
Yes.
I want to raise.
Oh shit. So Vane now owns the whorehouse, yeah?
You're the proud new owners of a brothel.
Let's hope no one notices.
I'm liking him more and more and more. Every episode, I'm liking him more.
That's Randall.
Why is Randall lying on my sofa?
Well, he's not exactly going to be leading the charge after the day he had yesterday.
Why are you chained to him?
So I don't try to run. Thank you.
Yeah, you ain't going nowhere.
To those of you owed credit, or for whom we held goods in consignment, I leave it to my daughter to see you made whole as best we can.
Oh, shit.
But once that is settled, our business with you must be considered complete. I'm very sorry. Godspeed to you all.
Oh, fuck. Is that really true, or is this... or is he just saying that just to get rid of everyone?
Even if the backstays hold at such an angle, and I wager they won't, the load on the sails will exceed capacity and she'll dig in hard at the bow.
She'll hold.
Hard enough to shake loose the rigging entirely.
Captain, Mr. De Gruyt makes a good point. The speed we'll pick up will come with dire risks for the ship. But I think she could take it.
Go on, Miri.
Raise up the gallants!
Raise up the gallants, come on. Fuck.
Bring her up into it.
See, this is what I wanted. This is what I wanted to see. They're pirates. They should be out at sea doing shit. Fuck. I like that. Okay.
As for our future here, I'm working on a deal that'll make a safe place for us among the farmers in the interior. When the pirates are gone, the landowners will drive commerce here. They'll be indispensable to the
Normans. Oh, okay, there you go.
So we will make allies of them.
So he wants to get rid of all the pirates and use the land as, like, farmers on the inland and stuff. Have a peaceful life. So it's safe for his daughter. Coming for you. Coming for you.
She'll have a boot on your throat and a hand in your fucking pocket.
I think he's talking about you.
We go straight at her.
Without the bow chasers, we'll be sitting what? Ducks for her guns. She'll rake us bow to stern.
Not to mention, we'll be boarding bow to midship.
We just need Captain Bryson to cooperate and bring the Andromache about for us to do so.
And how the hell do we get him to do that?
Mr. Beauclerc is going to convince him.
The fuck? How the fuck is he going to convince him to do that?
I keep accounts. That's what I'm good at.
Every man on this crew had a first time. You're overdue.
But I've never even shot a pistol.
Well, that's all right. Half the time, they don't even fire.
Oh, Harry Potter looks so scared.
You're going to be all right.
Is he gonna die? It's gonna be his first time and he's gonna die. What's he gonna do?
Fire! Fire! Fire!
Oh fuck.
Mr. Beauclerc!
Oh shit! Sniper! That's crazy, man! I had no idea that they had snipers back then. Oh, it's working. Oh man.
On the rail!
Look at them all sat there waiting, ready. Oof. Yeah, I think Harry Potter's gonna die. Oof. Oh fuck. Go on, Harry Potter. In a way, this is really, really smart writing because we've never done this before as well. So to kind of play it through him and from his kind of standpoint. Fuck. Go on, Harry Potter. Fuck. Almost ripped his fucking throat open.
Dufresne.
Oh, they took the ship. Fuck yeah, man.
We have relationships with the merchants and customs men that kept my father's trade moving.
Your father said he'll take no part in any further.
They're my relationships now.
Ooh, take it over.
You know that I want nothing more than to make this place strong and stable. I think you want the same things. Bless this endeavor and we can have them.
I'll do that.
How are you?
The moment you lift the ban on Captain Vane.
Ooh.
Show everyone your motive here is for the common good. Show them that you can be trusted to keep petty animosities separate from business. Rescind the ban on Captain Vane and show me that.
Yep.
Do it and I'll back you as your father's successor here.
It is true, man. Like, you gotta put aside your petty fucking personal problems for business. You know? Fuck yeah, man. Ooh, you fucked it. What the fuck?
I do apologize for this. Mr. Guthrie's orders were explicit. No matter what, I was to make sure that you were on this ship.
Whole shit.
You sided with his daughter against him. You forgot your duty. You must have known there would be consequences.
Wow.
Do it.
What?
And this one.
What's it do? What's it do? Massive. Massive.
Oh, I hope this guy fucking dies real slow and painful. The fuck?
What the hell are you talking about?
Chaz.
Where the fuck is he going now?
Captain Flint. Mwansale.
He says, I'm securing the hold below. But 20 of my men, I can wait, but you cannot.
Captain Tony Scarborough.
Before departing, I sent a message to the captain of the Scarborough. I told him where I was headed, and I told him where he would find you.
What?
God.
The Scarborough!
Oh shit! Fuck. Whole shit. Wow, okay. First and foremost, like I said earlier, I think Eleanor definitely needs to put aside her personal problems with Captain Vane if she wants to do business. It's common sense, you know. As long as she keeps that ban on Vane, she ain't never going to be able to build anything. You know, especially from the ashes of what her father is attempting to destroy now, you know. I think, obviously, she will. I don't think she's going to be that stubborn. I think she will. But now the question is she going to go and try and save Max? And is that pirate lady, is it Annie Bonnie? Is she going to try and help Max escape? Or, like, I don't know, but I can see something kind of coming of that. And Vane, where's Vane gone? I mean, he's gone off on a little boat, so I can't imagine him going that far. It might have something to do with the scar that he's got on his chest. But it all depends on where he's going to have to go, you know? But then right at the end there, man, they take the fucking ship. Like, right now, it's still season one. So, like, a lot of the names is still kind of flaky in my head. So, like, the names of the ships are even worse, like... but Flint, they finally attacked that ship, got on board, but the captain and all the guns, I would assume, are stuck down deep in the guts of the ship. That's if there are any guns still on the ship. I've just got this feeling that they were all taken off and put somewhere safe on land. I think it was a complete misdirection, you know. But they're stuck down there while this other ship has turned up now, coming in for the rescue. So, the fuck, man. Didn't they call it the Scarborough? I think that's what they called it, the Scarborough. I'm sure that's been referred to in the past on the show. Like, I've said this before on other shows. It's kind of hard for me to kind of, like, for the names to kind of stick in my head. Give it a few episodes. Let me really get into it and I'll be... winging off names left and right, man. Honestly, though, I think this might be my favourite episode so far. You know, just loads of action, just... hell yeah, man. Alright, give this video a thumb up if you like it. Comment down below, let me know what you think. And subscribe if you haven't already, man. Alright, I've been Sith Furion. I'll catch you in the next one.